and everyone there is in between. It's an honor for me to stand in front of you distinguished people and share my 2 bits. Often people ask me how I chose I want to become a chef. And out of valid expectations, I say I learned it from the ladies in my family and how it's always been like destiny to me. But it hasn't. It's been like a caterpillar of coincidences where few people appreciated me and some small compliments gave me the courage to try cooking something new. I vaguely remember a cake, baking a cake when I was 8 years old using Coca-Cola, which my aunt once taught me. My father had it and he said, "Yum, it's delicious." That night I went to bed thinking I have it in me to be a good cook and, you know, I'll try hard and I'm going to press more harder on the taste buds and experiment and create more delicious recipes. Years later, my mother told me it was pathetic and gooey. On the hindsight, I think today I'm standing here in front of you all as a chef. It is only possible because my father, he did not cut my wings even before I learned how to fly. Human aspirations are often afforded by small words which are given to us by people who are there with us since the beginning of our journey. And they, willingly or not, form an indispensable part of our success. And what I truly feel is that these words create an energy and a sense of positivism for us, which takes us ahead in life. The world is full of 2 kinds of people. The one Venn diagram here represents those who appreciate, and the other Venn diagram here represents those who criticize. The second Venn diagram has more population. I would request you all to be a part of the first group. Also, because I heard there's less competition there. Moving on, of course, having a great support system is a good thing, but we all have detractors. When I was in the competition in London, in Young Chef, the parents of my fellow participants were very critical of other participants. And when you are a shark in the ocean and you do not hunt, you soon should be hunted. Another way to succeed is to let the fishes believe that they are to be hunted. So the constant inputs which I kept getting from other parents was that, "Garima, you failed to create an exciting enough dish." And I was met with a lot of nervousness before each round. And as I'm reminding you about the first slide when I spoke about the people who belong to the criticism group. Then there was my mother who traveled with me to London and she told me, "Beta, they are only doing this because they want you to perform better. They want you to do justice to your talents and use their criticisms constructively." And I said to myself, "Okay, maybe mom's right." Being the naive kid, I believed her. And I let her incidentally manipulate me into believing that yes, there's a lot of scope for improvement in whatever needs to be done. After some time, I realized it's my mom's God-gifted talent to convince me into believing whatever she says. But yes, that's added a lot of advantage to my career and has made me reach where I am today. This is the heat a wet clay requires to solidify. And I often wonder if every child who has a dream and is supported by their parents gets this right heat which is required. Because the world is there to critique you at every juncture. All you need is your family to support you. But don't get me wrong, folks. I'm not trying to coerce you into being better parents through this narration. All I'm trying to say that if you give the responsibility to your child and say that, okay, fine, go dream. But you should also let them have the freedom to dream whatever they wish to. If I would tell my child, go and have a dream, when choose between being a doctor, an engineer, or a cricketer, and I would say, I don't consider any other talent of yours, and all I care about is whether you learn theories and write them down. And that's the cruel judgment which I would be passing through you, whether you can learn what's taught to you, write it down on a piece of paper, and I would be judging you just based on that, whether you complete it within the next 60 minutes or not. Well, that is cruel. let's face it, when was the last time that you used this formula on the screen? When was the last time that you used this formula on the screen, the Sridharacharya's formula, to calculate that what decimal of time would you be late by to read somewhere? When was the last time that you were asked that Babur invaded India in which year? When was the last time were you asked that who's the famous poet in Akbar's palace? Let's face it, educationists have made us believe that the world would crumble without them under pressure. I agree we need basic knowledge, but it's not the be-all and end-all of us. We need to realize that if today chefs stop preparing food, the world will definitely crumble. Moving on, if farmers stopped working, there would be an interstellar-like situation in India where everyone's moving every few months, but not to find any place because of the traffic jam.